Hi, let's talk about the major vascular pathways of the head and neck. In this video, I'll provide you with a high-level overview of the major arteries, veins, and lymphatics, which are serving the head, neck, and upper limbs. So let's start with the arteries. The aorta, which is the major conduit of arterial blood through the body, begins as the ascending aorta, which leaves the left ventricle of the heart. That ascending aorta transitions into the arch of the aorta, and then the arch of the aorta into the descending aorta. That descending aorta has two parts. There's the thoracic aorta, which is the aorta as it traverses the thorax. And then on the other side of the diaphragm, we have the abdominal aorta, which is the aorta which is found in the abdominal pelvic cavity. Coming off of the arch of the aorta typically are three major branches. The first being the brachiocephalic, the second being the left common carotid artery, and the third being the left subclavian artery. The brachiocephalic artery is going to ascend from the superior mediastinum into the root of the neck, and there it's going to bifurcate into the right common carotid artery and the right subclavian artery. The subclavian arteries serve the upper limb, the thorax, and the neck, as well as parts of the brain and spinal cord. The common carotid arteries are going to bifurcate, and there's a lot of variation here, typically at about the level of C3, C4, into internal carotid arteries, which will continue up to the base of the skull, and they'll enter into the carotid canal. Once they're inside the skull, these internal carotid arteries are going to serve the contents of the cranial cavity, namely the brain and spinal cord. They'll also serve the orbit, eye, and the periorbital region, especially the forehead. The external carotid artery is not going to enter the skull, but rather it's going to serve the face and superficial head, and also have some branches in the neck as well. Now we can see that there isn't a paired brachiocephalic trunk. That only is going to serve the right side of the body. The left common carotid is a direct branch of the arch of the aorta, as is the left subclavian vein. And while vessels between the right and left aren't perfectly bilaterally symmetrical, we can generally assume that if the right subclavian artery has a branch, then the left subclavian artery will typically also have that branch. And the same holds true for right and left common carotid arteries. So the most we see with respect to asymmetry from a very high level is the presence of this brachiocephalic trunk. Veins are a little more symmetrical. So veins are going to drain blood back to the heart, specifically in this case to the right atrium of the heart. And this is very high level. So coming down from the cranium, in particular from the jugular foramina, are the internal jugular veins, right and left internal jugular veins. These internal jugular veins are draining the head, the face, the cranial cavity of the head, as well as elements of the neck. And they are joined by the subclavian veins. So we have a left and a right subclavian vein. Subclavian veins are going to drain the structures that the subclavian arteries supply. So Predominantly the upper limbs, but they also help to drain the thorax and elements of the head and neck as well. And the region where these veins come together are known as the venous angles. So that would be the right venous angle. And this is the left venous angle. And the venous angle is the origin for the brachiocephalic veins. So on the right here, we have the right brachiocephalic vein. And on the left brachiocephalic vein. And I really want you to take notice of the asymmetry here of the brachiocephalic veins. A lot of people will conceptualize these as sort of a simple Y, but that's not the case at all. The right brachiocephalic vein is a little more vertical and in line with the superior vena cava, whereas the left brachiocephalic vein is longer and more oblique. So we can see that it's a much easier straight shot into the superior vena cava from the right than it is the left brachiocephalic vein. And this left brachiocephalic vein is going to overlie those arch of the aorta branches, so brachiocephalic trunk and left common carotid and left subclavian veins as well. Moving right along, it's important that you understand the concept of those venous angles. So there's the right venous angle and there is the left venous angle, because these are going to be important players with respect to lymphatic drainage. So the cardiovascular system is able to deliver and then reabsorb materials at the level of capillary beds all throughout the body. These capillary beds have a myriad of forces at play, but generally the movement of materials out of these capillary beds is greater than the return of materials to these capillary beds. Now, over a long enough period of time, even the smallest drip can turn into a flood. And so what we have as a solution is the lymphatic system. So the lymphatic system consists of lymphatic tissues and organs. They're specialized capillary beds that exist, that thread throughout active capillary beds of the cardiovascular system, and they absorb all of that excess interstitial fluid. And they transport that fluid, which is lymph, through a series of trunks. These trunks have clusters of lymph nodes throughout that the lymph travels through, and as it does so, antigen-presenting cells can present pieces of pathogens to elements of the immune system, T cells and B cells and whatnot. But eventually, all of that lymph is going to drain back into venous supply at the left and right venous angles. So let's start with the right venous angle and work our way out. I think that it's probably the simplest thing to do here. So conceptually, on the right side, we have the right lymphatic duct. And that right lymphatic duct is draining in the vicinity of the right venous angle. It can be on the right IJ, it can be on the right subclavian, it can be on the right brachiocephalic vein, but somewhere in there we have the right duct. That right duct is going to drain several other ducts. So accompanying the IJV is the jugular trunk. Accompanying the subclavian vein is the subclavian trunk. And ascending the mediastinum and helping drain the lungs is that bronchomediastinal trunk. And the three of these trunks drain into the right lymphatic duct, which then drains into the vicinity of the right venous angle. Here, we can see all of the structures that are drained by the right lymphatic duct. So the right side of the head and neck, the right upper limb, and the right thorax all have their lymph drained into the right duct. This is a huge asymmetry because on the left side, we have the thoracic duct. The thoracic duct drains the remainder of the body. So the left head and neck, the left upper limb, the left thorax, and everything below the diaphragm. So various trunks are going to feed into the cisterna chyli, which is that distal dilation of the thoracic duct. And the thoracic duct ascends out of the retroperitoneal space of the abdomen, and it goes up through the thorax. It ascends. It crosses over from the right side to the left side at about, you know, T4, T5-ish. So that's about at the boundary of the superior mediastinum from the remainder of the mediastina. And then it ascends on the left side, and then it wraps around the common carotid and IJ, and then it inserts into the vicinity of the left venous angle. Now that thoracic duct also drains the jugular trunk on the left side, the subclavian trunk on the left side, and the bronchomediastinal trunk on the left side as well. So whatever trunks exist generally on the right, those trunks also exist on the left. It's just an asymmetry in terms of drainage pattern of duct that we see this asymmetry of lymphatic drainage throughout. So let's look at a cadaveric photograph and see what we're able to identify. So we see a very long and oblique left brachiocephalic vein. Here's a very distended left IJ. Here's the left subclavian traveling across. So there is our left venous angle. And coming up out of the superior mediastinum, I'll just go lateral to it, right there, it's this structure, it's the thoracic duct. There it is, wrapping around the common carotid artery, the vagus nerve, IJ, and there it is inserting into the left venous angle. The thoracic duct, cadaverically, sometimes is very tricky to distinguish from surrounding structures. It usually looks quite venous in nature. Sometimes it may have a slight green tinge to it, but more often than not, it's going to look like a vein without the blood in it. So keep an eye out for that thoracic duct, especially in the root of the neck. So let's end with a question to assess your understanding of what we've just discussed. So while dissecting in the lab, a student noticed a long oblique venous structure crossing the superior mediastinum. When they cut through the structure, they found wire leads from a pacemaker. Which vessel did they dissect? Was it the left brachiocephalic vein, the right brachiocephalic vein, the left subclavian vein, the right subclavian vein, or the superior vena cava? So we're talking about the superior mediastinum, and I see a long oblique venous. So we know that it has to be a vein. Vein doesn't really cut down on all of this, but long and oblique certainly does. That's going to eliminate the right brachiocephalic vein. The left and right subclavian veins are long, but they're not particularly oblique, so that can diminish that. Superior vena cava is more vertically oriented. And that leaves us with A, the left brachiocephalic vein. So if you recall, the brachiocephalic veins form from the subclavian and IJ. The right is a little more vertically oriented with respect to the superior vena cava, whereas the left is longer and more oblique. The reason why they find pacemaker wires there is a very common place to implant a pacemaker. It's in the left pectoral region, and those wire leads then traverse the subclavian vein, the left brachiocephalic vein, and the superior vena cava on the way down into the heart. Thank you very much for your time.